Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Well, welcome here at all, and the people who left early, fuck them. The question is, am I warmed up from doing those other two albums, or am I tired out? Warmed up. How many people have just joined us now? Yeah, that? One, two. So you're all here before. Yeah. I don't want to tell the same old anecdotes or same old things. I have to come up with new stuff. The year, ladies and gentlemen, was 1983. A weird year. It was a very weird year. And the church who made its third album called Seance. And it came out and went straight into the charts at number 13. And then I went on a holiday to Europe. And after about a month, I was troubled and I rang up Marty Wilson Piper and said, I had a dream that our album went in the charts at 13 and then fell back out the next week. And he said, it did. He said, no, that's what happened. Went in at 13, it was like an upper number. So that was it. That was Seance for you. Went down like a lead balloon. And I had, there's a bit of controversy surrounding the mix. The guy mixed it. Oh, you've all heard of that before. This guy named Monet did his thing, and it was at sort of odds with what the record was supposed to be, and it was all a bit of a mishmash. But looking back now, it's sort of, a lot of people in America say, oh, Seance is my favorite record by the church. And sort of a weird, it's a weird record. All right, therefore, without further ado, adieu is what I say at the end. Adieu, ladies and gentlemen. So without further ado, because I don't want to talk my time away, like almost happened in the last one. Lucky there's a clock up here, I can see where I'm up to. I've already wasted almost 10 minutes, can you believe that, without playing a single fucking note or saying anything you didn't know. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to give you a seance. Smile like a tiny child. She talks her head off and her land lies wide. Toss and turn on a teardrop sleep. All those dark clouds who are looking for me and the fly. She pointed up into the sky. And he comes and he tried, and they fly. They left when she lost her breath. Hastens off to some unknown day. Trapped inside her painted eyes. Self into the new sunrise and the fly. She pointed up into the sky. And you can't touch them if you try. Yeah, they fly. Yeah. tell me, is everything unplanned? It's all so unexpected, but I just don't understand. We run so hard and always end up in the same place. Life that went so smoothly, well, that never is the case. One day, down the sky is bright. I will shake away the shadows of eternity. It's just a storm before the calm, but the life held in your palm is great. One day. And you stand there with ashes blowing past, dipping into guilt and love that will be made at last. And the gold you spend and the hiss of the net that you throw into the sea, coming back 100-fold, baby, there's no guarantee. One day, doubtless clouds rise, will shake away the shadow of eternity. Just a dawn before the calm, like the life in your palm is waiting. One day. I will shake away the shadow of eternity. Just a storm before the calm, like the laughter in your palm is great. One day, what can be like just with all the honest men? Go back to my blindness so that I can see again. A woman standing on a hill, gazing out to sea, dreaming of a new way, waiting there for me. I call her from a distance as she saw into the sun. A man and goddess begin their dance, for their time has begun. And holy wars ascended, and the battlefields of men are washed away for God. In the perfect rain, princes, kings, and other things are well worn and bent. And messengers from everywhere, embers have been sent. Ba 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 ba. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, thank you.
One of them's my gin, one of them's my water. Eeny, meeny, miny. O-U-T spells gin, in you must go.
There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, we now come to what's called the third song on the first slide. I'm trying to think of a music anecdote for this one. I can't think of any music anecdotes about seance. I suggested we were going to have a tour, and I suggested we should call it The Church Contact the Living. I was being really facetious, checking, that's a good idea. And there was the church, Contact the Living, which was a frivolous suggestion. All right, let's get on with this one. alone. At the end of the day, as I stand before the railing of what used to be you and me, I turn with those tears in your eyes, not understanding that you were free, free of me. One face away turns into like the words I think so again. And as the city goes, electric people, nobody knows. Electric dream, no one probably shows. And you touch my skin, feeling is electric, electric, electric. Electric.
Do you want to have a chance saying electric?
Electric.
That's coming back around, so we'll have another chance at the end, okay? I like that. I like the way some people were slightly out of time. It gave it a humanity and an authenticity that I'm searching for.
I hope that our destiny is slow. Ever upwards, now it comes away and falls. Rain on the windows of children. I see the future just sliding away and falls. And as the city goes, electric people, nobody knows. Electric dreams, nobody shows. When you touch my skin, feeling is electric, electric, very electric.
You can add very if you like.
Electric.
Anybody to sing electric in that song. It's like the possibilities, the implications are stunning. All right. We made this video of Richard Lowenstein.
This post-apocalyptic. There's a lot of post-apocalyptic stuff going on there. It was a very Melbourne video. And we, what's that sound? It sounds like an elephant outside the door.
We went to this place in South Melbourne that was like an old warehouse, and we could sort of walk around lighting fires and smashing windows and stuff. And we was like, it was a post-apocalyptic world.
But I was still sitting around a fire huddled there, singing my fucking song. Even though it's post-apocalyptic.
It's very hard to keep saying that.
Post-apocalyptic. Mental note, work on saying post-apocalyptic. It's not a good word to fuck up. So we did this song. It's, the song's called It's No Reason. Do Remember that one?
Yes.
Did it race to the top of the charts? Did it race to the middle of the charts? Did it get played on 3XY once at 4 in the morning?
Crocodile skin water, city shadows wave. Put your hands into my head, your name is so brave. Buy a ride to sundown, buy a ticket home. Take all the things I've got, leave all the rest alone. Marble skin turned human,
all fades to grey. Put your hand into my hand,
make them go away. As your crying is softly, you won't ever be disturbed.
Red on pink, the sun will sing.
Have you even heard? Now the colors take me down. It's no reason to be sad. How did you hear without a sound? It's no reason to be glad.
It's there somewhere.
Salty tears are wasted, children lie away.
Put your head into my hand, let your spirit break.
Black smoke from the chimneys,
white smoke from the hills. Everything is moving, puppets standing still.
And colors take me down. It's no reason to be sad. And you leave without a sound. It's no reason to be glad.
Next song, I said, was a stoned out jam that should have never made it into the studio, let alone made it back out again. You've got to love that. Alright. I know. Jamming's bad, but writing's good. What are you doing with jamming? Oh. No, we're writing. Oh. Why did you think we wrote about jamming? Of course, it's worth repeating this old chestnut, this anecdote, which is getting a telegram from the Queen next week if I say it again. We're working on these songs, and they didn't. The songs are starfish. And she said, "Gilby, where are the lyrics?" I just haven't got them yet. He went, "What are you going to do? Just make them up?" Yeah. Oh, wow, we really... You know what? I know people who are interested in time will be impressed by this. This is... You know, there's a lot of things you can say about me, but it's now 9:30, dead on the knocker where I should be. At the end of side one. I'm bringing this one in. We're right exactly where we should be. I don't want to get it wrong. I don't want to end 5 minutes too soon, 5 minutes too early. I want to give, I don't want anybody saying, "He spent 45 minutes on that one. My favorite song had 15 minutes." I'm evening it up, all right? So we're now on the second side of seance, okay? And here's this song. It's a terrible one if you fuck it up.
Thank you. bump into my sleep. Well, it wasn't just a thing to do, it was a thing to actually learn enough. I could never get that nearly. What do you expect me to do? Disappear? We're as free as we can be. Can't you see? Like a tree so unseen. Penguin. The message disturbs me, I throw it to the wind. And after all these hellos, goodbyes, etc., we can't stop this thing again. It's like a fog you walk towards, but never seem to leave. Every morning now, I hear that same old song. An old singer is long dead. His voice goes on and on and on and on. Of news you have to learn, beauty you can't see. Wait to find you gone, until necessary relay. Well, I just had to laugh for things you'll never hear. Hear me say, now I sing, you will never hear. What do you expect me to do? Disappear? You and me, we're as free as we can be. Don't you see? Life will change so obviously.
It wasn't perfect. It wasn't perfect. I mean. It was authentic. Permits a multitude of sins. Well, as I was saying before, I've had another cookie. I had another brownie. They're very unpredictable. When you mix them with alcohol and AstraZeneca, the results are very unpredictable. Ladies and gentlemen, you know I'm a poor, starving, miserable musician with absolutely nothing who lives in abject poverty in a two-bedroom flat in Coogee.
But with a great work ethic.
So, me and my whore are only paying me $1 million to do this show. And if you don't buy some merch, I don't know what's going to happen. If you don't buy some merch, I mean, Christmas is only 358 days away. And you know what? What a statement if you have an enemy you really don't like, you buy him some of my arty-farty merchandise. He's like, what the fuck did you give me this stupid Ganesha pillowcase for? I barrack for Carlton, mate. What the fuck is this? So a great way, even if you don't like my pretentious merchandise, overpriced t-shirts fall apart, books of letters, words fall off the page, it's all untrue, the records, the CDs are scratched. What else? The pillowcases, they're all used, stolen. There you go, stolen from a hotel in India where I stayed once, and passing them off as my own. Ladies and gentlemen, just imagine the statement, the impact you can have with some Steve Kilby merchandise purchased here. They're like a memory of solidified of what a wonderful night you've had tonight. All the people who just joined us before for the seance and Heyday, thank you very much for coming out tonight. Unfortunately, a few people, and I can really understand that, that they didn't decide to. After three times, we almost got there, and all the people who could have seen it could have seen it. That would have been great. But I really appreciate the people who did come tonight. I really did. I respect that. Thank you. I tell you what, 2 years of playing Instagram gigs make you suddenly go, wow, the audience is a really good thing. The audience. I remember the audience. And it's really wonderful to actually play to an audience, especially in a lovely venue, a lovely, civilized audience. It's nice atmosphere in here, and I'm really enjoying myself. So, thank you. I drove down the coast road, you know. Yeah, I couldn't fucking... The rules getting on a flight, I was like, which way is the wind? Which test do you have, how many minutes before you get on the flight? It was just so I decided to drive down. I drove down on the coast road. Yeah, stopped in Cannon River. And wow, as soon as you get into Victoria, everything's really nice. It's true. Now I'm going to Marlow. I'm going to get a residency at a pub in Marlow and play Creedence Clearwater. Looking for a job in the city, working old man. I'm sitting in a deck chair, and that's it. I've become a Victorian at last. For sure. I tell you what, in an alternative universe, you can think of a lot of better ways to spend the rest of my miserable life. I'm sitting in a deck chair in Marlow playing Proud Mary. Meanwhile, ladies and gentlemen, sorry for that digression. All right, I'm charging no extra for digressions tonight. All the anecdotes, the banter, the repartee, that's kind of dodgy. The repartee, and it was a very wooden performance. It was repartee. It all comes free of charge. It's all just to put you in the picture so you feel what it's like. In 1983, I want you walking down the street. It's 1983. And in 1983, Richard Pluger and I were sort of in some stage of arrested development. And our favorite thing in life was static electricity. Wow, could you have some fun if you had these boots? We used to get these boots made by a guy in Richmond. He's not there anymore. And the whole band would go, I want that color and that color and that color and that color. Pluke had fucking pink Beetle boots. I had green ones. The other guys had silver. Anyway, we had these boots, and something about the property of them, really, if you got on the right sort of nylon carpet on a very dry day, and you had a key, you could really, in the EMI studios, you could give someone a huge shock. A big blue spark would jump out the end of the key. And also, there were a pair of plastic trees. As you walk through the vestibule, on a day like that, if you'd worked up enough charge, you'd see the shocked faces of a boy who's there to deliver a veggie burger. And as he walks through, both plastic trees would bend over and give him a massive fucking blue shock in each ear. So the trees go, fuck! And Pluga and I loved it. And so I wrote this song about it. This is a song. This is Stuart Coop, that famous journalist. He said that this was the most meaningless song he'd ever heard, and he was wrong. It's full of meaning. How could you cram more meaning in there? I'd get done by the Poetic Association for oversaturating the meaning. Electric lash. Trees in the studio feels my head fly. Only the voice of a girl on the radio falling from a high. I turn to leave,
It's the fair cameo, it doesn't feel quite right. Only one thing ever really known fits day or night. I speak and I love her, and I suspect she already knows. I was asking me so very, very clearly, even when they're closed. Electric lights of trees in the studio by Ella Caress. Only the voice of a girl on the radio drifting from the west. I'm turned to leave, as if it can be old moon, not guess. Only one thing you ever really know in my curse. Before you bless our eyes, me and I love her. I suspect she already knows. How's I see me so very, very clearly, even when they're close.
Strange thing happened just when Seance came out. Dire Straits asked if we could open for them on their tour of Australia, which was very strange. And suddenly we're in these great big rooms, like entertainment centers where we'd never played before, playing to an audience who didn't really like us very much. And I remember sitting backstage, and all we had was one half empty bottle of soda water. And I was like, fucking Dire Straits. Suddenly the door opened, Mark Knopfler was there with his headband on. And he said, hey, boys, how are you? You right for drinks? And yeah, Mark, yeah. Good, boys, good. And he walked off. And we didn't even say, no, we don't have any drinks. We had our chance. And we never told him. That's interesting to know, isn't it? Yeah. That's something you didn't imagine happening. The church sitting there in there, a guy said we had putrid paisley shirts buttoned up to the neck. See, I remember all the bad reviews. Richard Plouc's drumming turned tempting mysteries into turgid mistakes. Turgid. All right, that's one thing, there aren't so many rock critics around anymore. Not really many like there used to be, so guys you'd be really scared of if they gave you a bad review. They sort of don't exist. The ones who write only write nice things now. It's sort of gone out of demand, the critic with those really nasty ones that used to sort of make me cry. and I got a bad review in English Press. My book went down to the record import record shop and bought my special NME the week it came out. I didn't find it had a bad review. No, inevitably, people in Australia would find that out 3 months later. Because there was a lag. All right, so we're halfway through the second side of Sands, ladies and gentlemen. Got a little number for you called Now I Wonder Why. In a moment of triumph, I found a beat of control. In a second of honor, a dispatch I can know. She gives me a taste, she showed me something to give. I wasn't looking for you, and I don't want to find you yet. In an uncovered window, in a street full of room, following the garden and pursuing the blues. The world is so wide, she never sees me anymore. But I trusted you then, and I'm trusting you still. It's just now I'm not so sure. Now I wonder why I thought I could ever lose. But the game is only what I choose. Now I wonder why. It was somebody, a woman, who was a delicate crime. And I've been waiting for ages, I've been here all the time. Was this greed in my blood? Let me take the easy way. Help me hide the vagabond that was myself yesterday. And during the dream, I found that I couldn't sleep. And during my acting, I found that I was too deep. By the virtue of faith, I knew I could be lost beyond this dark place. Unprepared to pay the cost. Now I wonder why I thought I could ever lose. But the game was hardly what I should. I wonder why. Was this green in my blood? She let me take the easy way. She tells me I'm a vagabond, but I trusted you then. They show me some magic again. I knew I could be lost. I knew I could be lost. I knew I could be lost. Thank you. Is this all right? Is this okay? I can't tell. Really? Wow, thank you so much. got one voice going, wow, you're doing really well, and another's going, man, man. All right. Well, okay, so we're coming to the second last song of Seance now. It's a little number for dropping names. Anybody said to me, what advice have you got for a young kid about to get in the music business? I said, be able to manage time. When you get on stage and you're hired for 45 minutes, don't play for 40, don't play for 50. 45 minutes. Know what 45 minutes feels like. Get in touch with time. That's been my advice, seriously. That's how I got here. I still can't play and sing, but I can apportionate 4 albums out in 2-hour sets, an hour break in the middle, deliver it all smack bang on the end, even play that other song, have 5 minutes for that other song that you're probably going to want at the end of the other one that doesn't on any other albums, you probably still want to hear it. I've got to get that. You don't want to hear that. See, now you're sending me mixed messages. Okay, well, you've got a warning, so have a warning. At the end, that could possibly rear its head. Okay? All right. So, here we go. We've got the last track on Seance coming up. And then we'll be back into Haiti. You know what you can do? It doesn't change. Would you like to do that?
Yes.
Only if you don't, not if you don't, you know. If you're beyond that, but if you would like to. Okay. What? You want to do it? Okay. Don't break my balls.
We want to do it.
Okay, you know? Yeah, it's not so easy.
We
Okay, we're gonna have it. People wanna do it, people don't wanna do it, don't do it. People do it nice, and it's like a whisper insinuating itself into your consciousness. Okay? It doesn't change. Okay? Do you wanna have it all? Okay, here we go. Sinking silk, burning gold, touch you as the air is turning cold. Seeing things, just rest a while as the tide sweeps out and out. It doesn't change. It doesn't change. Sad. No, I can't remember the piece. So on to thinking where I have, I can't remember that phrase. Is it seeing things? Seeing, no, that's the second. It's there, it's just coming around the treadmill, it's on the treadmill. What's that? I'm going to go right back to the beginning, so you can have a chance to sing, it doesn't change us. Yeah. No, you're going to enjoy it, so we're going to do it properly. No, I've signed a deal with me and my wolf, don't not do the songs properly. Oh. Sinking silk, burning gold, touch you as the air is turning cold. Seeing things, just rest a while as the tide sweeps down on the mile. It inside the man, pleasure dome. This is a world that I once had known. The perfume dead, the taste of fear, shrug your shoulders and they disappear. Strangers in the naked skin, waiting for their sweet oblivion. They said it couldn't be done. They say we won't be able to do 4 albums in one night. And they will. Yeah, look, I'm ready. I'm ready to take on Heyday. I've still got a bit of petrol left in the tank to get this one through, get this one over the line, discharge my responsibilities, make the audience happy. Collect my money. Okay, that's the easy bit. Here's the hard bit. Stay in Melbourne until Thursday without getting the you-know-what. And then do that gig and not get the you-know-what. And then do that gig and then not get the you-know-what. And then collect my money and drive all the way back to Sydney up the old Coast Road and not get the you-know-what. And all the guys who are in my band on Thursday and Friday not get the you-know-what as well. I don't like the results. I'm happy that I just got to Mimo Hall and finally, but if you are around on Thursday and Friday and you feel like stepping out, Thornbury Theatre, me and a really crack band. Yep, they're all on crack, for sure. I have a really good band. The reason for this is the church couldn't do any gigs because we had a guy in Melbourne and we had a guy in Brisbane, we had a guy in Alabama. We couldn't play, and this guy said, why don't you just go out with get a really good band and just play the church singles. So that's what this is, just playing all the church singles up until Ripple. And that's happening at the Thornbury Theatre. If you'd like to come along, if you like, if I don't know what to say, if you feel like it. I understand if you don't. Alright, so ladies and gentlemen, cast your minds back to 1985. Things were pretty nice. Things were nice. They were very nice. I had a Renault Fleurie sports car, which looked really good but went really badly. It only had an eight cylinder engine, Tony. It only had a four-cylinder engine, a tiny 800cc. It was a four-cylinder engine with 800cc. And this guy I knew said, you should drop a 1600 engine in there. They're meant for it. And I said, yeah. I paid a lot of money and waited a long time. When the 1600 engine went in, I could drive it from Balmain to Bondi and it would boil over. So that's all I did. I drive to Bondi, the car would boil. I'd have a swim, get in and drive it back to Roselle World and boil again. Gee, it looked good, didn't it? It really fucking looked good. Huh? That's all that mattered. I was living in Roselle. And every day, me and Richard Plouffe would catch the bus into town where we're making our brand new album with a guy called Peter Walsh. Did you ever meet him? I was doing a gig one night. I said, Peter Walsh was this young Englishman with rosy cheeks. And Marty said, now tell them about his face. Peter Walsh, he was a very cherubic looking young Englishman. He was only 22 or 23. Seems unbelievable. Long blonde hair. And after our first run through, we were walking down the street and he went, Steve, going what? He said, Richard keeps holding hands with me. I said, he's just showing you he likes you. Because Richard was a bit of a situationist. Anyway, Peter Walsh was a wonderful gentleman. We made a great record with him called Heyday. And I guess I'm going to lay that on you right now. With any interesting annotations I can come up with. This first song is called Myrrh. I went to Holland and I was doing an interview with a Dutch journalist and he said, this song Myrrh? I said, yeah. He said, it's about the three wise guys. Summoning up the suitable gravitas. So just asking for the gods of rock and roll to give me the energy. I just got this new app. And it sort of gives you charisma and energy if you reflect that old performer on stage. And you suck on, no drugs. You suck on this thing and something full of energy and inspiration and charisma again. And mystery. An enigma. All right, here we go. And the horn and all the giant, now medicine to Jericho City. Camel dust heralds our arrival. New cries from the drunken moon. Hold on to your fences again. In the slipstream full of the feral men, they plummet in some seamless night down into this hopeless sin. Apache coming in the boiling crowd, we never got to meet you last time. We're interrupted by a telephone. You didn't think they were invented then. Hold on with your miracles. We need more wine and gold.
We need slaves and roads and the personal favors. We need microphones and manifolds. How can we be so invisible? You never know us to sing. Privilege on privilege, a mount to discovery. So now cruising down this shuddering highway, dead sunshine on my back. Yeah, I'll ditch about the way people treat me back there. They hollow off with pain in their eyes. Oh my Lord, trust your intention. Money strangles my love. Yeah, I'm struggling like a fool with my junk and my jewel. You would have thought I'd had enough. How can you be so invisible? You made the noise to sing. Privilege on privilege, I'm on to discovery.
It was around this period, maybe before that, I discovered you could scratch secret messages onto vinyl. You know where it runs out? And one day I was looking at this some record and someone said, look at this. I went, wow, can we do that? And I went, yeah, you just do it in mastering. So we put some things on there. People asked me what they mean. And one of them was... The young English knob twiddler versus the boys from Bondi. Did you ever see that one? The young English knob twiddler versus the boys from Bondi. And we used to spend, it was a very expensive studio, and we spent like 3/4 of our time playing pinball with Peter Walsh. And they had a Kiss pinball machine. Fucking Kiss. And you know what? When you got a replay, the sound was so satisfying. It was this deep, earthy, the machine, and you'd get a replay, and it was this fucking, it was like an addiction, an obsession to keep getting these replays on the Kiss machine. And Peter Walsh would get joined in, the whole band, Peter Walsh, be playing pinball all day instead of making our record. Anyway, here's the second song on the record. I don't like to blow my own horn, but who else in 1985 was writing songs about polar ice caps melting down? Hawaii? Right? Okay. I was there being a prophet of doom a long time ago. Here in this desert, beneath the sun and stars, troubled by the rumbling, million distant cars. And please be good to me tonight. Let me find my way. Yeah, there's some commanding I cannot disobey. Gunfire. I'd say a murder about me. All these deeds and world needs I must shrug off today. All my life spent searching for prowess left me lying here with you, Tristan. I was working in an orchard. It grew strange as fruit. It wasn't Mother Nature that made those trees say move. The children can't hear you, they only want you blue. You hold on to the instant like a
never believed you were in distress. Now you've gone and left them with yourself. Ah, water and flame. Ah, fire burning out. No, the ice melting down, 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 down. The fire burnt out. The hotel suite in a rich man's town. I heard in Botany Bay, a prisoner by my own device, a mountain in my way. I'm gonna have to alter my trains. I can't stay much longer with just status. I make all this carnival progress. Invited by our queen tonight, Tristan.
Thank you. I think I'm over singing that one a bit. No? Over singing. Okay. I was outside a court once for a matter in Sydney, yeah? I was outside the court. Well, it's too late now. Obviously I got off. Look, I was outside a court and I was standing there not feeling very happy. And I noticed the guy taking pictures of me. I walked over and said, "What are you doing?" He said, "Taking pictures of you." I said, "Why?" He went, "Because you're an icon." I don't want to do it. I have to. I work for the Daily Telegraph. So there you go. Being an icon isn't all it's cracked up to be. In fact, I'd rather be a daikon, which is a sort of Chinese pickle. All right, moving right along, ladies and gentlemen, come to the third track. The third track on Hey Day. It's a little number called It's Already Yesterday. It's already yesterday. We're off the calendar. I heard those sirens play, just like an orchestra. Mechanical bird of prey, sing for your emperor. Clouds broken, flash of blood, still in the camera. We won't feel those locks and chains. We won't listen to voices in the city rain. Giving the orders, another morning I'll be gone. I'll stop the car for 10 miles, beach or maybe Avalon. Across the water, it's already yesterday. Nobody's answering. Disconnected, drift away. Nobody's questioning. Head up, silver feet of clay. Who is surrendering? They've fallen out again. I am remembering. I don't feel those locks and shame. I won't listen to the lizard part of the rain. Give in the orders. Another morning I'll be gone. I'll stop the car for 10 miles. The baby out of love. Over the water. Do you want to do the choir bit?
Kumbaya, my love. Kumbaya. Kumbaya, my love. Kumbaya. I won't feel as excited. I won't listen to voices in the city rain. Give it up, all of us. Another morning I'll be gone. I'll stop the car for Violet Town. Or maybe Babylon. Over the world.
Fucking song. I never liked this song.
Okay. It's already yesterday. That's it. Oh, you can't win them all. You couldn't expect me to play 40 songs and get them all right. That's okay, if you were hearing earlier show I'm counting then, that's like two really serious train wrecks, alright? That's not. Please don't ask for your money back. I'm supporting my grandson through college. Okay, now we come to the fourth song on the record, the fourth song on Heyday. It's a little number called Columbus. Something changed within him, shut up, don't him know. Suppose there'd be room in here somewhere for me. I think I just need someone's words to reassure me. I don't blame any of you. I don't blame myself. I'm waiting for my small reward. It's gonna come somehow. You don't possess a single empty tear or furrowed brow. Oh, Columbus, I wish that you could see us now. You don't suppose there'll be room in me somewhere for me. I think I just need someone's words to reassure me. I don't blame any of you. I don't blame myself. The man had something strange about him. Should I told him no? Oh, Columbus, I wish I never let you go. You don't suppose there'll be room in me somewhere for me. I think I just need someone's words to reassure me. I don't blame any of you. I don't blame myself. Memo will have provided me with a really, I think, quite attractive town. Do you like it? This town will be able to produce triplets if used correctly. Alright, thank you, Memo Hall, at least giving me that decent towel. Some places, you know, play some really swanky place and the towel's hopeless. I really judge a gig on the towel.
absorbency is my main priority. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, now we've got our, an instrumental. So I'm just gonna like be the orchestra, okay? And you can join in if you like. Okay? It actually sounded good. I can write it here. I hear the people doing instruments, it's all mixing around, and the smoke. I thought this was a smokeless venue. It's like someone's just had a pack of Rothmans, Benson and Hedges, and Lambert and Butlers. All right. So that's it. That's the end of side one. That's the end of side one on Heyday. And we turned over side two. Running a little ahead of myself here. It's only 25 past 10. And this song wasn't supposed to happen till 10:30. Quickly, think. It was a sunny day in Roselle, and white clouds skipped across the sky as Richard Klug's familiar face greeted me on the bus, the 441. From White Bay into town, where we were going to make Heyday with Peter Walsh. And Klug and I used to go to esoteric bookshops and just stand there and read like lines and words that impressed us. And then we'd go back to the studio spouting stuff from these books that we, there was an esoteric bookshop in Sydney, in a mall, we went up and they had all these sort of Madame Blavatsky. Have you ever read her books? Madame Blavatsky. We didn't read them, we just would get a great line and Klug go, "Wow, man, luxury and punishment," or something, you know? And I go, "Wow, listen to this. Do what they will should be the whole of the law." You know what I mean? We traded lines. And then we'd go back to EMI, and then we'd always We'd always have veggie burgers. We have tempeh burgers from Laurie's Vegetarian. Yes. Tempeh burgers with satay sauce and guacamole.
Guacamole?
And satay sauce. You wouldn't think those things together. And I used to have double tempeh. And a soy milk smoothie.
I'm a veggie. I love this.
Great. Every day, that's what we have, the same old thing. Anyway,
well, look at that.
Anyway, so one day we wrote this song. Peter Coppers got on the drum kit, and he was a really good drummer, and he started going. And we wrote this song, which I'm about to do now. But I can't sort of keep that up, so I sort of have to reapproach it in a kind of a more civilized fashion for me to do at 10:30 on the night in 2022, after all that's happened in intervening time. I can't do that, so I've sort of got this new interesting version. I hope you find it interesting. God, I've been asleep so long, I've been away. Back from software limbo, it is cold day. I let the promises bind me. I let seductive logic blind me. I embrace the machine and through the routine. I hid from the people who try to find me. Till the day comes when you realize otherwise. You never cared. Pandora's box reveals a new surprise. Can't wait to see your eyes. Well, you've been times alive. 101 voluptuous days I broke the law. Labyrinth was closing, so I panicked at the door. I let the wanton flesh obsess me. I let all those drugs obsess me. I was hired and fired, I was never inspired. Flattering chatter and words to impress me. All that glitter had me mesmerized. Otherwise, well, I never did. To guess a nature of our enterprise. Can't stop to sympathize. Penguin, you've been times alive. I turned up in this harsh doom city on another plane. I couldn't believe the room I got. I guess I entertained. I let the dirty streets around me. I let the buzzing swamp around me. I gave money to those I saw in my hoods, but never got off the stuff that's around me. Till the day comes when you realize. And if you understand, you've been tamed. Have me mesmerized. Can't stop to sympathize. Well, you've been times alive. Dehydration, gin, wheat cookies.
Do you want my water?
I'll toss some water. I just like to complain. I'm gonna have some water now.
Hope I can get myself over the line. Where is the line?
Do you have a line? Do you want to come party?
I hope things will align. I hope things will align for a line later on. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm just going to toast you once again. Thank you for coming here. I'm not just stalling for time. I am very dehydrated and a little light-headed and dizzy. Thanks for coming here tonight. We're going to move right along now with Hayday.
Thank you for being here. Thank you for being here.
What's that?
Thank you for being here. Are you single?
No. Tony Wilde is single.
He's single. Who's Johnny?
He's... Don't get me started. All right, so we're going to move right along now. This is a little song called Disenchanted. I haven't done this one a lot. I hope I can pull this one off for you, okay?
Well, look at you. That's what I always wanted to have. Saying sweet life is a downright drag, down to the very last seat in the back, like it's never gonna end. And the sea is true. Summer slipped under his neighborhood. I'd like to hold on to it if I could. Now I'm gonna have to let you go for good. Your disenchanted friend. They say that character you play is rising fast. And you get drunk, take a half second jump and experience it as a pass. This is it, the closer you get, closer you go, deeper than ever seen. Do you enjoy the game? Say the dirty of this time up there. Do you get used to dreaming and fighting? Audition for the part of Mr. Strength. Well, I know him personally, and this hotel's a zoo. You gotta be a creature to get a room in me. You can live like a king on a throne of two. It's a lighted long way from the sun here. And his rays inevitably. They say that character you play is rising fast. And you get drunk, take a half second jump and experience it as a boss. But this is it, the closer you get, the deeper you go, the tighter the net of sleep. Success is a song of war. Now they don't see what your persistence is for. You used to be unknown, now you're about to explore. You wanna be on the show, now you're about to go. And it's never gonna end. They say that character you play is rising fast. You get drunk, half second jump and experience it as a boss. This is it, the closer you get, the deeper you go, the tighter the net looks to me.
Thank you.
Yeah, but that's not part of this. Sorry.
Emma, moving on.
I can't understand the question because I'm so deaf and your voice is so soft. Did you say play the first song I ever wrote for the first girl I ever loved?
Yes.
I don't know what that was. And that's not part of the thing. And the member will sue me if I don't just play what I'm... What a member will say, don't fucking play anything else. Huh? I can play... I'm playing all the rest of the songs. You know your best friend. Okay, moving right along, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry I can't do that request. I'm sorry I can't do your request. I wish I could. It'd be really cool if I could pull a song out. Oh, my first love. How I love you so much. My first love. Actually, that's pretty good, isn't it? Perhaps Barnum could do that one if he comes back out of retirement. Oh, my first love, my first love. My first love. Ooh. Okay, alright. But seriously, the next song is coming up and we've only got three to go. And I've gotten through. I'm going to ring Guinness Book of Records. I said I played four albums in a row of Memo Hall. No one's ever done that before. I'm going to buy a chalet in Switzerland. I'm going to buy a white Swiss Shepherd. All right. Now we have the third last song, ladies and gentlemen. It's called Night of Light.
Human tragedy is definitely a remedy. Send my love upstairs to me. She used to be the enemy. I let her go into the night. A remedy. Send my love upstairs to me. She used to be a symphony. I let her go into the night. Night of light, satellite, quiet sight to see. Since I tell me when it's over, I'm trying to write my book. She's broken down, it's raining. I said I'd have a look.
Calling human tragedy is definitely a comedy. She reads my story back to me. She said I live this chapter to eternity. I let her go into the night. Let her go into the night. Night
of light, satellite, quiet sight to see. Quiet a sight to see. Night of light, satellite, night of light, satellite, night of light.
Thank you. Have you ever heard the Beach Boys in this really weird version of You Are My Sunshine? All in minors. You are my sunshine, only sunshine. Make me happy, and life is great. And never know it, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. I just thought of that. Alright. Seriously though. We're working our way through Hey Day. We're up to a song called Youth Worshiper. You know the problem with Hey Day is the last two songs aren't very good. It starts off with a bang, and so when I got to the end, I was like, wow. Now I'm stuck with that. And so 34 years later, I'm stuck with playing these two slightly, they're all right.
You worship her, pity for men. You worship her, wrapped in blue fox and a red. You want the child back, you want an aphrodisiac to fill the crack with time. You worship her, goddess of ruin. You worship her like you know what you're doing. I've ever sung a break. Never touch your face again. Race against the time. Hold some, hold on, teeth I bone. Stitch you open, come on some.
South Bank with all my celebrity friends filming ourselves on Instagram as we celebrate deep in the night on the best champagne. All that stands between me and that fabulous getaway, that sumptuous luxury of the Rolls Royce, the seats which envelop you, all the things at your fingertips, is one song. That's all that stands between me and my getaway to that wonderful hotel. I have the entire penthouse. I'm overlooking Footscray. I've got to tell you, I don't always remember the words of this song. And it'd be a fucking disgrace if I forget the words to the last song and that's what you walk up in.
Oh, what a feeling, baby. Knowledge and brutality. Who's soul you're stealing, baby? Lost your immortality. Another empty conquest. Tina set me free. Set me free. Oh, what a feeling, Father. Father, why are you leaving me? They found another martyr. I'd rather it was him than me. They took away his language and his energy. He said, I'll never come back again. Never come back again. Never come back. Oh, what an ending, baby. Promise you remember me. I'm not pretending, baby, a sweet and wicked treachery. Water on my orchids, save my dynasty. I said I'll never come back again. 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 Never come back again.
I've done it. If this is a movie, if my life was a movie, The Marathon Runner, I'd be breaking through the ring now in slow motion. And I've done it. They said you can't do it. My doctor said, don't do it. My lawyer said, don't do it. My accountant said, do it. I said, I don't know if I can do it. I don't know if I can take it. He said, do it. You fucking get down to Mimo Hall and fucking play, my boy. Yeah? GST is rolling around. I really appreciate, I've said all this before, let me reiterate, it was very damn decent and civilized and good and brave of you to come out at all tonight and see this thing. How sad I would have been without you people who have come here. It really is a wonderful thing. That you came here tonight. I do really appreciate it. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I have 10 minutes up my sleeve. Do you want to hear that song?
Yeah!
What?
Yeah.
Fighter pilot?
Yeah.
No. Not fighter pilot. Not. I'm just gonna be a boring old crowd pleasing guy, just playing the same old fucking thing.
Yeah.
All right. Let's all take a deep breath in. Let it go. This is a serious song. I don't want any smiling or levity while I play this. Say again, Mr. Tony Wilde, thanks for regaling me of days in the old days. The old days when we used to get in the Donald Duck and hit the frog and toad. And you had your 8-day clock in your rain of land. All right, it's been a real pleasure being here. I haven't got any advice, I don't know what to fucking do. Because my new album is called I'm Just a Singer, and not even a very good one. and I don't know what I'm doing. I want to tell you this, it's Kali Yuga. The coincidences are getting faster and faster. Weird stuff is happening. Dreams are coming true. Real life is taking on a bizarre quality. We all feel detached and distanced and strange. I really do. I always did, now I really do even fucking more. But I tell you what, you audience have been a great audience. I'm going to give you this song. I'm going to give you this song. And thank you for being here. And if you want to come to the Thornbury Theatre on Thursday and Friday night, I'm doing the church singles. Yeah, baby, the church singles. Don't forget the merch. Tony says, don't forget the merch. When was my birthday? I went into Thornbury, it's Thursday and Friday night. That's all I know. If everybody in the band gets there, if I get through without catching anything. Thornbury Theatre in Thornbury. Or for the zombies. Sometimes when this place gets kind of empty, some of the breath fades with the light. I think about loveless fascination, a little Milky Way tonight. Lower the curtain down in Malvern. Lower the curtain down on that. I've got no time for private consultation. A little Milky Way tonight. I knew what you were looking for. Might have known what you would find. And it's something quite peculiar. Something shimmering and white. Leaves you here. Despite your destination, a little Milky Way tonight. Wish I knew what you were looking for. Might have known what you would find. Wish I knew what you were looking for. Might have known what you would find.
Is that noise again?
Something shimmering and white. Did you hear? Despite your destination, a little Milky Way tonight. Wish I knew what you were looking for. Might have known what you would find. Wish I knew what you were looking for. Maybe you're looking for a Ganesha pillow. Might have known what you would find.
end of the Milky Way tonight. Under the Milky Way tonight. Under the Milky Way. Thank you so much, people. It's been really nice to be with you. I wish you all good luck. I wish you all a safe journey home. Good night.